How long will humanity survive in the universe? 70,000 years ago, human population was nearly wiped out by the Toba supervolcano. Another similar eruption will likely occur in the next 10,000 years. And a supervolcano is just one of the events that can threaten the survival of human civilization. The future is filled with danger. In this video, we will see what the major threats to humanity will be and how humans can survive them and extend the lifespan of our civilization. In fact, one of these threats is a threat that can destroy even a civilization that has already spread throughout a galaxy. Part 1. Surviving on Earth. The first threat to humanity is basically around the corner, which is the consequences of climate change caused by human activities. The increase in average temperature on the planet means more energy for the atmosphere to use in extreme weather events, ranging from severe storms to floods and droughts becoming more common. In addition to the short-term effects, global warming can cause the melting of the Wilkes subglacial basin, which could raise sea levels by 3 to 4 meters within the next 10,000 years. And the great danger here is not that climate change will kill all humans at once, but that a much hotter planet is incompatible with the existence of a technologically advanced civilization. If the worst-case scenario of climate change happens, it can destroy our industrial and scientific capacity. And without the ability to create new technologies, we will be in the perfect position to be victims of extreme disasters that will happen sooner or later. Without advanced technology, our extinction is a matter of time. Overcoming this challenge means preparing to deal with and mitigate the damages of extreme weather events and changes in the planet, but also learning to use cleaner forms of energy, especially nuclear fusion. Mastering nuclear fusion would revolutionize energy production globally. In addition to being a clean and ideal energy source, nuclear fusion can greatly aid in large-scale space exploration, which currently appears to be science fiction but will be crucial for the long-term survival of our species, as we will soon discover. If we learn to deal with the extreme events of the planet's climate, we will have survival guaranteed for the next million years. Or at least until we locate the first occurrence that is more than extremely severe, a catastrophic event. Like the fall of a large asteroid or the eruption of a supervolcano like Yellowstone's, and they can cause a huge destruction in a very immediate way, but the main danger is that they have the ability to drastically alter the planet's climate very quickly, causing artificial winters that can last for years and thus affect humanity's food production. If civilization wants to last a long time, we need to have mitigation and reconstruction plans to prevent an event like this from causing the collapse of everything we have built and will build. One thing I want to clarify is that this kind of threat doesn't necessarily impact us or will impact us in our lifetime. But if we think as humanity and in long periods of time, statistics do not play in our favor. In about 100 million years, another impact of similar intensity to the one that killed the dinosaurs will likely occur, for example. Any trace of us will have turned to dust by then, but possible living humans will need to deal with the problem. Fortunately, we are already learning to deal with asteroids through NASA's DART project. We literally made a probe collide with an asteroid and successfully changed its trajectory. And we already have a catalog of the most dangerous known asteroids, and we are constantly keeping an eye on them. The most perilous moments for fatal impact are the upcoming centuries, while we are still not completely capable of deflecting asteroids. And this skill will be extremely important in a million years. The solar system will experience an unrequested visitor. A star will pass through our solar system. The invader is the star Gliese 710, which is already coming towards us. A passage so close to the sun will cause extreme gravitational disturbances to the comets that currently inhabit the Oort cloud, which is a cloud of comets located at the edge of the solar system. A number of these comets will be redirected to the inner solar system, and an unprecedented comet shower will happen as a consequence. There is a very high chance that at least one of them will collide with Earth. And besides, there is a chance that this event will eject planet Earth as a whole from the solar system, turning our planet into an orphan planet. If this occurs and we still lack space colonies, it's game over for human civilization, which at this point would have lasted a maximum of 1 million years. And this stellar visit will not be anywhere near the only catastrophe that will threaten the life of Earth in the next millions of years. More extreme events will definitely occur. It is simply a matter of time. For instance, as time goes by, the sun will become increasingly hotter. This is the natural life process of our star, and with that, the Earth will become increasingly uninhabitable. Until about 1 billion years in the future, the average temperature of the planet will be around 47 degrees Celsius. People from Rio de Janeiro will crowd the Copacabana beaches, or better yet, the Copacabana desert. Because at this point, a good part of the ocean water will have already evaporated. So if humanity wants to last more than 1 billion years, we need to have an escape plan from Earth. Part 2, colonizing the solar system. If we want to survive as long as possible in the universe, we need to leave Earth and create functional colonies on Mars, the moons of Jupiter, and maybe even in space itself using generation ships. And this would significantly increase the lifespan of humanity. Doing this correctly, it is highly likely that humanity would be able to last until the end of the solar system, which is expected to occur in about 4 or 5 billion years. Or at least, that would be the case if gamma ray bursts did not exist. Gamma ray bursts are events so dramatic and energetic that they can wipe out life in an entire solar system in the blink of an eye. When a large star, more than 8 times the size of the Sun, runs out of fuel, it explodes in a supernova, releasing large amounts of energy. Some of this energy is released as gamma rays, which is an extremely dangerous high-energy radiation. Fortunately, this extreme radiation is only emitted in 2 specific directions during a supernova. Even if one occurs near the Sun, it's unlikely the worst gamma rays will impact our solar system. However, even rare occurrences occur sooner or later. Additionally, it is more probable than not that our solar system will experience impact from at least 1 gamma ray burst originating from a supernova within a time frame of 500 million years. And there is no solution for this. If a gamma ray burst hits your favorite star system, it will be sterilized almost instantly. All carbon-based molecules will be broken down by extreme radiation. In other words, colonizing our solar system would buy us a few hundred million years of survival, or even up to 1 billion years if we are very lucky with when the gamma rays will come. Yet even if life in the solar system can't survive this, humanity can endure and persist. If we want to survive for more than 500 million years, we will need to leave the solar system. Part 3, colonizing the galaxy. If we become proficient in nuclear-powered spacecraft, particularly nuclear fusion, it is feasible to explore the nearest stars to us during the span of a human's lifetime. That being said, these trips will not be short and will probably take decades. But if the idea is to keep humanity existing, we need to take enough people to have long and prosperous lives outside the solar system. The effective colonization of the galaxy and the creation of independent colonies from the solar system will not be an easy task. In fact, it'll be a huge technological challenge for which science still has no solution. So let's check out some sci-fi ideas. The least used version to colonize the galaxy is to use a generation ship, which is basically a society inside a ship. Instead of taking a few people at a time, we will take the whole humanity right away. And alongside a large number of people, we would also need to bring everything they need to stay alive. Food, water, and energy production. It is not obvious how feasible and realistic it would be to build a ship like this. On the other hand, the alternatives involve solving science problems with unknown solutions. For example, one of these problems is to discover how to make human beings biologically immortal, that is, to end aging and death from diseases, which would allow us to travel between the stars much more calmly. We could also acquire the ability to suspend and restart an individual's life utilizing cryogenics, which in theory could aid us in sending substantial dormant populations to other stars in a significantly more efficient manner. That being said, these two scenarios require new technologies that may not even be possible. And the ideal version for space colonization, at least in a practical way, would be to solve the difficult problem of consciousness and learn how to upload human minds into machines. Machines handle space hazards more effectively. So instead of sending humans inside spaceships to space, humans can serve as the spaceships. That said, this solution involves one of the toughest problems in science and one of the most heated debates in philosophy. If we reach the galaxy and become a civilization that colonizes other stars, this makes humanity basically indestructible. And there is only one phenomenon that can affect an entire galaxy and threaten humanity from this point on. Galactic collision. In 5 billion years, the Andromeda galaxy will collide and merge with the Milky Way. And the danger here is the radical version of a star's visit to the solar system. A galactic collision will cause an absurd level of gravitational instability around the entire Milky Way. And this can eject entire stellar systems into the void of space. If at this point humanity has colonies only in a few stars around the galaxy, there is a non-negligible chance that all of them will be affected by the collision. It would be ideal to have colonized good portions of the galaxy within the next 5 billion years. If we conquer the galaxy, we will receive the greatest prize when it comes to lifetime as a civilization. Humanity will have the ability to live in the universe for the entire star era, which is a period of 100 trillion years filled with prosperity. And then we will arrive at our ultimate stage of survival, part 4, the dark era. 100 trillion years is a long time, but that too will eventually pass. There is a phrase that I truly appreciate which states that the days are long, but the years are short. And in 100 trillion years, there will be only a few hundred shining stars in the galaxy. Our galaxy at this point will no longer be our galaxy. It will be a true giant monster resulting from the fusion of all the galaxies in our local group. Once the final stars cease to exist, there will be an absence of new stars and a lack of usable energy within the universe. If humanity reaches this point unprepared, it means erasing along with the stars. To go beyond, to inhabit the post-star universe, we need to change our attitude as a civilization after conquering the galaxy. And the ideal would be to start when the last galaxy of the local group merges with the Milky Way. From then, no new galactic event will happen. And from that point on, the focus of humanity would need to be on storing hydrogen for use after the natural end of the life of stars. If the first step to survive is to expand, the next step is to prevent stars from burning their energy sources quickly. This attitude would literally alter the course of history of the universe and provide us with additional time to live even after the universe fades away. Perhaps the final 100 stars illuminating in the galaxy are the ultimate shelters of humanity. But shelters that will not go out anytime soon, because humans have stored all the remaining hydrogen of the galaxy for these 100 stars. Or even better, humanity has saved all the hydrogen to use the most efficient energy source known in the cosmos, black holes. Nothing known generates energy on a scale like throwing matter into black holes. But in order to harness the energy of one, we have to learn how to basically build a cosmic dam. We will need to use the gas falling movement in the black hole as a source of energy, and besides, we would also need to capture the light emitted by the accretion disk around the black hole in order to somehow generate energy with it. These disks can shine much brighter than stars, and they produce energy extremely efficiently. Living around a black hole and using it as a source of energy would probably maximize our lifespan in the universe. That being said, black holes will continue to exist for trillions of trillions of trillions of trillions of trillions of trillions of years. In short, the lifespan of our civilization will depend on how far we go into the universe. If we never leave Earth, it is unlikely that we will last much longer than a few million years. If we reach the solar system, our lifespan jumps to almost 1 billion years. And conquering the galaxy would take us hundreds of trillions of years, or even more, depending on how much discipline we have in saving resources. But what about you? If you were to guess how long humanity will last, how many years would you guess? Thank you very much, and see you next time.